Anderson picks up 1,000th first-class wicket as Kent crumble. Lancashire are the leading team in the LV County Championship, top of their group by 4 points and looking imperious in the four-day format before the competition went on hiatus. Kent are winless in the tournament, but impressed in the Vitality Blast. Could that be the confidence boost they needed? After a day and a session was lost to the rain, Lancashire could finally unleash Jimmy Anderson. Back at Old Trafford and immediately into his work, England colleague Zach Crawley, his first victim, out for a duck in the first over. And he had another in his next over, Cox out cheaply too, the hosts making up for lost time. England's all-time wicket taker was showing his class once again and had a third with the score still in single figures. Ollie Robinson caught behind for a duck, Kent hopes of a decent start shredded. Everything he tried seemed to come off, and it wouldn't be long before he had a fourth in the game, leaning out for two, Anderson now with figures of 4 for 3. His next wicket was the big one. Coon, caught behind for a duck, gave Anderson his 5-wicket bag, but more importantly, it represented his 1,000th scalp in first-class cricket. Another incredible achievement to add to an already glittering career, and the celebrations show just how much it meant to his teammates. You'd be forgiven for thinking Lancashire only had one bowler, but Lamb proved just how dangerous their attack can be. The next ball saw him pick up his first, and the Red Roses' sixth, Denley departing LBW for 12. Anderson wasn't done though, not long to wait for his sixth wicket, Milnes the unfortunate man to go, caught behind for 1. And then a seventh for Jimmy, Kent now 8 down with little more than 30 on the board. The visitors though have their own legendary club veteran, and Stevens wasn't about to roll over for Lancashire. He helped his side to 50 runs, an achievement in itself considering the regularity with which wickets had been tumbling. But he wouldn't get much further. Out to Lamb, Davis with the catch at long off, Kent with just one more. Late hitting from Logan and Quinn took Kent into the 70s and spared some blushes, but Lamb wrapped it up. Kent all out for 74 and Lancashire in the driving seat. There simply aren't enough superlatives left in the English language to describe Jimmy Anderson and his latest milestone of 1,000 first-class wickets. He's in a class of his own, already transcending the sport, a giant of cricket, and his name a byword for unrivaled excellence. Kent were unfortunate to be on the wrong end of a spell of bowling that will be long remembered. Jennings and Davis look to be playing an entirely different game to their visitors. Their opening partnership a fruitful one, and worth 50 off a little more than 10 overs, brought up with consecutive Davis boundaries. And he was looking for 50, but fell short, out for 47 to Quinn. Lancashire were still trailing Kent, albeit by just 7 when Quinn had his second. Jennings out caught by Crawley for 14. Kent had another without any change to the score. Wells aimed a big swipe at Milnes, only to fall for 3. Bohannon and Villas finally took Lancashire past their visitors' score, both men patient in their approach, aware of the potential for more nervy moments before the close. And they would come to fruition, the captain out before the end of the day, Crawley clinging on in the slips off the bowling of Stevens, and Lancashire 4 down. Bohannon too couldn't make it to the close, bowled by James Logan on his Kent debut, and Lancashire were getting a little taste of their own medicine. Often Jones ensured Lancashire put on 3 figures, and they stuck together through to the end of the day. The hosts in control, but not quite as far on top as they'd have hoped when Kent crumbled to 74 all out. No matter the result though, this day will live long in the memory, if only for Jimmy Anderson's heroics.